told y'all I felt the energy change, right? So this is what she did. She started the hate and shit. She started the shade and shit. She started talking about me behind my back to her friends. She started tweeting about me on Twitter. She laughed at me having a black eye. She let her dog attack me. So many other shit that I can't even remember right now because it was 6 years ago. And there's so much other shit that I probably don't even know about, okay? I would say a few weeks before my birthday. And the rapper The Game, he had came to the club or whatever. I don't know what happened, but he came with his entourage. And I got into a fight with the girl that he was with. I think I was trying to get over, like, sit on the couch that she was sitting at, and she kept, like, telling me to move. Like, I think she kept, like, pushing me away. Hey, Baltimore came to fucking Houston. I mean, and she going crazy. It was like bananas. When I say I beat the shit out this girl, I did not know this girl. And I bet you to this day, she probably like, when I beat somebody up, I beat them bad. And it's always it's always a memorable fight. Like, it's always a memorable ass whooping. So I know the person that I beat their ass, I know they be thinking about that shit years later. Like, I got my ass whooped. And Brittany and everybody and her entourage, all her homegirls crowding around me. Oh my god, you beat the shit out of her. Oh my, like they never seen a fight like that. And clearly they didn't. None of them bitches is like that. Them bitches ain't really into no shit. Bitch boyfriend gas and then everybody gas and then everybody talking about me whipping this girl ass. So Brittany, you knew I still had that same energy in me that I had when we were kids. Still tried me. I just couldn't believe that. Like, you gotta have balls. I mean, big ones. But anyway, let's get into my birthday. Birthday came. My birthday is January 3rd. Capricorn shit. Me and Brittany's birthday is like a few weeks apart. She is late December and I'm January 3rd. We had fun. I will never forget, I paid to get my makeup done. We all, even though the energy was still really weird and off, the bitch was never a real bitch to come up to me and say what was really on her chest and how she really felt. And this is what I didn't like. The bitch went around telling people she know that she know. They don't know me, so they gonna go with whatever you say. And I'm sure anybody that know you know, if they watch this shit, they know, like, oh yeah, that's exactly how that bitch is. I couldn't believe that bitch went around talking about, started shading her. I started going off on her on Twitter. I started being on the phone in her house talking about her on the phone with my aunt. I started doing all this stuff first. She didn't tell the people. I started working and I was working. And I was doing what I was bringing food in this bitch. I was doing what I was supposed to do. Tell them that bitch started hating and she wanted to find a motherfucking problem with me. She changed the energy. It changed, like, she was starting doing shady shit. You laughing at me getting a black eye. Like, bitch, you supposed to be my peoples. I will never watch a nigga whip your ass and sit there and laugh in your face because you got a black eye. Like, where the fuck they do that at? A hating ass bitch. A bitch that's mad. I mean, that's happy that my face got messed up, right? Am I right or right? Am I right or wrong? Doing this, Cabrina doing that. And this is what gaslighting is. This is what a narcissistic bitch would do. Start some shit. Start this energy. Be the one that's really hating. The one that's really jealous. The one that's really envious. And that the next bitch do better than you. This is something you would do. Go around talking about something. So she wanted to basically, once it went down, before it went down, she wanted to let everybody know, oh, it was her. It was her. It wasn't me. It was her. Do what the fuck I said I was going to do. And you was really hating. You don't have no type of ambitions. You don't have no type of goals. I've never seen you have no type of plan. You literally be content with, oh, I'm going to go to work this week on this day and that's just it. And I think, and I know that's where the hate came in when it came to me. And this girl, mind you, we in her city. Who know how to do hair? My birthday coming up. Mind y'all, I am a unique top out person. Back home, I've been having custom made outfits. Been having fucking making sure I go get my hair done by the best. I've been fucking paying for the best. I'm very high maintenance. I don't give a fuck how much it costs. If I want it to look like that, I'm gonna pay for it to look like that. Not really wanting to tell me who do this and that, because she did not want me to look bad. She looked it on her birthday, and it's so crazy because I know that's why when we was at LV Live on my birthday, the bitch was sitting in the section. She ain't want to party. I partied with her on her birthday, but she didn't want to party with me on my birthday. She wanted to just sit in the section and sit there and just watch a bitch. I know she probably was looking at me like, that bitch is just a Barbie. Like, she is gorgeous. I ended up making things happen on my own. I went to She's So Happy Hair. I called them. I set an appointment. I went to their salon. I went and got my hair done. I bought the bundles from them. I went and got my hair done. I sat in the salon, got my hair done, and it came up to like $700 that day. When I came home from getting my hair done, she didn't want to take me to go get it done. I guess she really thought she was going to be able to do all these hateful, jealous, hating ass shit, and I wasn't going to react because she took me to work, because it was real shady, everything. I came home, my hair was done. That bitch was pissed. Ha! Took my motherfucking hair down. I will never forget. It was so big. I will never forget that hair. That was one of my favorite hairstyles I ever had. This shit was so big. It was so curly. It was so long. I got me a hot pink custom made outfit. I ended up getting a section at her club. The nigga that she set me up with, he and his broke ass is in my section drinking off my bottles and all this other stuff. And anyway, it's my birthday. I'm trying to have fun. I'm looking fine as a biz. I wish I still had my fucking pictures from that night. So anyway, I'm looking good as a bitch. My homeboy came back from Baltimore. The nigga surprised me. I'm leaving from my motherfucking party. I'm on my way to V Live. This nigga come out the motherfucking car with, pull up on the side of the motherfucking car, thousands of fucking dollars. I was so fucking happy because I was already sad because I felt like I had nobody to spend my birthday with and party with. And then it was just real weird. So he really made me happy when I seen him. And I was already drunk, fucked up and all that. So I'm on my way to V Live. My nigga made sure I was full pockets full before little baby was full pockets full on my birthday, my nigga. I didn't even have pockets in my custom made outfit, but I just put my money. It was money right here, money right here, money right here, money right there. When I say shout out to some motherfucking Tyree, that nigga made sure I was lit. I can't even remember how much he gave me, but he just gave me a few dollars and just said, hey. My nigga, when I say I went in V Live and I showed the fuck out, I was looking so fucking good. I had so much money on me. The big blow up happened because my birthday came. I was enjoying it too much. I was sitting too fucking pretty. She was really mad. She the type of bitch that she kept on trying to throw obstacles and challenges in my way. And every time I overcame those challenges and obstacles, she was mad as a bitch. Wanted me to not have my hair done for my birthday. And I ended up still making that happen. Let me tell you one thing. One thing for sure, two things for certain. God do not fucking play about me. He blesses and blesses. Like, she did not want me to be that girl. She did not want me to get that attention with. The nigga that I met and was dealing with in Houston, that was a first time thing for me, my nigga. Besides Keith. Go watch that story time. Link in the description. Besides him. And that literally was the only other broke ass nigga I ever dealt with in my entire life. Ugh. Any hate just hit the fucking fan. My birthday festivities was going on for an entire weekend. We on our way home. It's me, Brittany, my sister, and my homeboy in the car. Who's the fuck that? I'm drunk as fuck. I'm talking to my boyfriend on the phone. I can't remember what we was talking about, but we was going back and forth or whatever. Oh, I think he said he had got stabbed. And I was like, what the fuck is going on? Celebrating me comes with a lot of hate and jealousy. And I don't know why, but when it comes to me celebrating other people, I do that shit with so much joy and so much passion. I be so happy. And I'm like, this, what the fuck? I'm yelling like, oh my God, da, da, da. Long story short. Brittany, calm the fuck down. Shut the fuck up. Da, 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 da. Mind you, we already had these weeks of tension being built up. Bitches talking slick out their neck. Rumors, lies. All type of shit coming back to me. You tweeting, we in the same house. All this shit is being built the fuck up. Did this bitch just tell me shut the fuck up and I'm on my mother phone where I pay my motherfucking bill? Did she just tell me? You done fucked up, right? You know you done fucked up, right? In the car, we fussing and fighting. We get to the house. I wanted to fight Brittany while we was in the car. Brittany trying to leave me now. But I think her boyfriend was like, no, go back and get her. So they come back and get me. We get in the car. We get home. We get to her house. I knew once we got to this girl house that I was going to beat the fuck out of her. I knew that's what was going the fuck down. Point blank period. We ain't talking about it. None of that. She was going to be putting my motherfucking clothes out. Not the money that made me break the fucking window at the end. But we going to get to that. Not the money that I had in the house, but she put out my clothes. So she puts my clothes out. I'm banging on the door trying to get in that door. Yo, when I got in that door, when I say me, Brittany, her boyfriend, his brother, which is what's my boyfriend, my sister all know this to be truth. When I say I tore her ass up like her mother should have tore her ass up years ago, black the fuck out, and I couldn't control myself. I could literally see the fear in her nigga eyes, my nigga, because she ain't no fucking fighter. She talked that shit and she's not like that. I used to whip this girl ass when we were young. Like, I used to really bully her. I'm whooping this bitch. Your boyfriend was kept on trying to be in the middle. He was so scared for me to get to her. I picked up a motherfucking glass Ciroc bottle and I lunged that bitch at Brittany. What? What? That shit just smashed on her. Oh my God. Yo, chill the fuck out. Her boyfriend telling his brother, yo, get her, yo. Hold her the fuck back. Hold her the fuck back. Da da da. Back, da da da. My nigga, Brittany, you can see the fear in your eyes, my nigga. You can see it in your nigga eyes. Like, that nigga really did not want you to get hurt that night. Like, I ain't gonna lie. Shout out to him. That nigga did not want you to be hurt that night because he was scared to death, my nigga. Like, the nigga was really her fucking security. Bitch, I was whooping her ass every time I got her. That nigga kept on saying, yo, because mind you, he don't know me like that either. That nigga was like, yo, you beat the shit out of her. Like, he kept bragging on that shit. He just couldn't believe I knew how to fight like that. And he was just like, this, yo, you beat the shit out of her. We was talking about it for the rest of the night. But before we get to the rest of the night, my money. She put my shit outside. She did not want to give me my money. I took the biggest fucking brick I can find. Mind you, this bitch window is like this big. Now, did you not know I threw that bitch in her motherfucker? Wash. Whole shit. I say I went out with a motherfucking bang. We running from the scene like we criminals at his house. At this point, I know I'm leaving Houston. I'm getting the fuck up out of there. I booked my ticket. I'm out of this bitch. I don't give a fuck. Deuces. I had my time when I had it. Y'all bitches some haters. I'm out. So y'all, I wake up the next day. Very important part of the story. When I woke up the next day after the crazy blackout and me woke up, I had on a white skirt that night and I had on like a different color shirt. When I say I woke up and it was blood everywhere, all over my body. I wish I still had the skirt, still had the evidence of that shit. So y'all see that it was just like a massacre. Like, I went in that bitch in the slaughterhouse and I chopped some shit up and I left. When I left, all was wrong with me was my nails was off my finger and that's it. No scratches, no nothing. Literally, like, who blood was that? I booked my flight. I know I'm on my way out of this motherfucking city. And I'm going the fuck back home, okay? I already been wanting to go home. Come back home was one of my biggest fucking blessings of my life. Literally, as soon as I came home, I got a new car. As soon as I came home, I went back to dancing. And I ain't gonna lie, y'all. I've made the most money I've ever made in my dancing career when I came back home. It was like motherfuckers had me a welcome home. Fucking 101s, wrapping that shit up, putting it in the bag. I had my boyfriend bought me my first car, then he bought me my second car, then he bought me my third car. Went back to what I was used to. Reminds y'all, we still was following each other on Twitter. So I posted my new car talking about some, oh, I hate when people only get stuff to shove it or shove it in somebody's face or do it because somebody, some all this weird shit. I said, girl, you just gonna be a hater for the rest of your life. For the rest of your fucking life in this video, God don't play about me. And let's just say I got blessed with abundance and literally car after car, happiness, happy weight, everything. My career, my licenses that I got, like just everything when I came back to Baltimore. It was literally a blessing in disguise. Oh, we cannot forget what the intentions was. I almost let you get away with it. You know, I ended up finding out the reason why Brittany wanted me to come to Houston was because her and her broke ass boyfriend that be stealing out of wall. These motherfuckers, I didn't know this was real big in Houston. I ain't no pimping and hoeing and all that shit was real big in Houston until I got there. I was so green, my nigga. Do you not know these bitches, these niggas had in their mind that they was gonna pimp me out? They was gonna sell my pussy or something? Like, literally, this is what was said by brothers and cousins and mother, like, people that is in y'all circle. How you know you got the same mindset as your mothers, your brothers, your cousins, and all y'all. Y'all all criminals, drug addicts, just a hot ass fucking mess. That's how you know. Like, who even thinks of some shit like that? Like, who thinks of, oh, let me beg my cousin to come out here. I know she trying to follow dreams, but little does she know when she get out here, she gonna be selling her pussy for me. Like, where they do that at? That's why you got your fucking karma. Like, that's exactly why you got your motherfucking karma. And a bitch like me is just sitting here blessed. I need y'all to give this video a thumbs up. If y'all want more story times, give it a thumbs up. Like this video. Subscribe. Turn on that bell. And I will see you guys in my next video. And make sure y'all leave y'all comments down below. Because this shit was crazy. Bitches is crazy. Bitches is haters. Always known. Bitches is haters.